Hello everyone and welcome to Beyond the Mask, where we talk about all things Scream. If you're interested in Scream content or you just love Ghostface in general, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and make sure you hit the bell icon to stay notified for future content. Just a notice that by hitting subscribe today, you're becoming part of our Scream community, in which I'm posting polls, discussions and the latest news about Scream every single day, and you can take part in all that by hitting subscribe. Today we're going to be reversing time and taking a look at MTV Scream, and I'm not talking about Scream Season 3. I'm talking about season 1 to 2, because I've been doing a lot of videos on Scream 2022 lately, and today I want to take a look at the TV series, because a continuation of the actual original TV series is still up in the air at the moment, only because nothing's been confirmed, nothing's been sort of revealed to the public yet, apart from a couple of hints and an actual leaker who leaked the information. I heard from someone that they were actually sitting back and waiting to see how successful Scream 2022 would be, and because of the success of it, I do think it's inevitable that at some point this year we will get the announcement that we're going to be getting an actual continuation of the first two seasons set in Lakewood. But today I'm not covering this. I'm covering something completely different, something that I wasn't actually aware of until I recently did some research myself. I actually managed to find out that Wes Craven gave his opinion on the TV show before he passed, and that was just something I was quite interested in reading. I wanted to know what Wes Craven thought about the TV show, but in order to explain this to you guys, I'm going to have to tell you what actually happened with the production of this TV show. So when the TV show was actually announced by MTV in June 2012, they said it was in the early stages of production. And one of the things that came to light shortly after was that Wes Craven was going to serve as a director of the show. And if he wasn't going to be a director of the show, he was going to direct a couple of episodes. He was approached and he actually posted on Twitter saying that he'd heard that people had been wondering what was going on with the show. And his response was that he'd been approached, but it depended on the script whether he was going to be involved or not. And then shortly afterwards, this was shortly after that tweet, he confirmed he was going to be a part of it, saying that he thought it would be fun. But then between that time and afterwards, it was pretty quiet on the Wes Craven front with regards to the TV show. So what actually went wrong? Well, I seem to have discovered exactly what happened. Apparently Wes Craven actually spoke about the TV show around the time of it airing, which was actually really close to his death in August, because the TV show aired in June of 2015. But nevertheless, he was actually asked about his opinion on it. And one of the things that he actually said, despite the fact that they did continue to credit him as being an executive producer and so on, he was actually a silent producer and had no involvement in the TV show at all. He then went on to say, with the TV's decision to change the Ghostface mask, that it was a case of, why fix something that's not broke? It appears to me that what actually happened with Wes Craven's involvement, he was involved, he was approached to be involved in the TV show, and he said that it would go off the script, but he was very vocal around the time of the TV show airing that he was not fond of the idea that they changed the mask. He believed that the Ghostface mask should have stayed there, because Wes Craven was someone who fought very hard to get the rights to use the Ghostface mask in Scream 1996, so much so that when Fun World initially declined, he decided that he was going to go out of his way to try and find a way to replicate the mask. So changing the mask was not going to be something that Wes Craven was going to be fond of, and I believe that the decision to change the mask was the reason why Wes Craven did not get involved with the TV show. He also went on to say that he didn't really want to express an opinion on the TV series. His only involvement in this would be if he believed the script was good. That highlights to me that Wes Craven believed that the script for the TV show just was not good enough, because he would have been involved and would have sat there in the director's seat alongside all of the rest of the crew if he believed it was a good enough script to carry the Scream franchise, but he didn't. And I happen to agree with Wes Craven on this. I believe changing the actual mask was one of the biggest mistakes that the TV series made, and I believe whoever came up with that decision was stupid. The Ghostface mask is so associated with the Scream franchise, to sort of change that mask does alienate fans of it. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I am actually a fan of the TV show. I enjoyed it for what it was. At the time when I first watched it, I remember being really hooked on it, but I completely respect people who don't enjoy it because I understand that all your faults and your opinions are valid. But Wes Craven seemed to not enjoy where the show was going as well, not just with the actual script, but with also how they changed the mask. But what I want to know is from you guys, do you believe that keeping the Ghostface mask on that TV show would have helped improve its quality, or do you believe the inclusion of the mask wouldn't save the show from the actual fate it ended up having? As always, I'm always interested in hearing your thoughts on this. Thank you very much for watching this video, guys. Don't forget to like this video, that lets me know that you're enjoying this content. If you're interested in more Scream TV show videos, I've actually been doing a plan to start covering some aspects of the TV show in future videos, so if you're interested in that kind of stuff, then make sure you hit subscribe. Make sure you stay notified because I don't want you to miss out on any videos that I do. And also, if you're interested in more Scream 2022 content, there's still more of that to come as well. Without further ado, I'm going to leave this video on a quote from the TV show itself.
What did you do to him?
It's what you're going to do. That's the real bitch. I suggest you run.
You like scary?